Fox Luca, Sharp Trades. Today was a bit of a difficult session with market open lower that triggered some sell-off. It was down 1.5% in the pre-market. Recover some and it closed right where I wanted to see it, above the 80 May and above this high at 430.60. The number volume increase. And it's below the 3MA. So now that's the next piece that we need to add to this puzzle to get a reversal. Now we're seeing this kind of bounce, and then the following day opens lower and goes down. Expect that scenario, it's possible. The market is still bullish, but there are some little bit of fear. We've seen the VIX going up over the past few days, 3 days, and today popped. And so if this escalates, the market will continue to pull back. So there's some selling going on. But again, the close was positive. If you look at the triple Q, the Nasdaq is very similar pattern, also close above the 18A. IWM, this one is the weakest of all the patterns and is forming this top, the Russell 2000. Big consolidation. Now, is this a top and a rollover? It's a possibility, or it could be doing what Amazon did some time ago. It formed this long pattern and then eventually broke. So, Amazon, by the way, very strong today, another reversal pressing. It reached my target today at 37. 59, 99, or to the penny. Unbelievable. And 4,000, 42 and 45 moving forward. Fantastic. When a breakout like that occurs, expect a rally. After a year of a consolidation, big move. And it's happening. All right, so anyway, into the individual stocks. Looking at Alec, this is a swing idea that is working well. Reached the target here at 39, closed well today, testing again this resistance at 39. I need to see a break above this recent high, 40.39, before we can see the next targets, 43.59. Eventually, if it's able to break above the high, we are into all-time high territories with 49 and 55 targets moving forward. The support is the 30. This high, the closing price 35 and then the 80 MA. ARPO, a very good day trade within a few dollar range, so was at 240 the opening and made a good run first part of the opening. A pullback retest held steady at 243 support. Came back above the VWP and then ran to the target. At that point, pulled back and broke the channel bottom. It was done for me. It stabilized above the VWP, so this might have more to go, and volume is very strong on the daily chart. So if you're planning to swing it, 4, 5, and 6.52, the support, half of this candle, so that will be around 250, and today low at 220. It's a biotech. BIGC, this added to the swing idea yesterday as a breakout, pullback retesting, currently holding. I like that got a bounce of the 80 MA and the trend line and close above the 3 MA, the green line. So let's see if we get pushed through this recent high 72.20. My target is 74, 80 and 87. Support 80 MA and this red candle low at 62. Boot got a bounce also. And by the way, many of the stocks that got a bounce have a potential to go higher, especially the market. If the market recovers, if the market goes lower, it will take down most of them, if not all of them. Anyway, Boot got a bounce off the 50 simple moving average. That's the line in the sand. We need to see it back above the 83, 84 level. And eventually a breakout above this all-time high at 86.70 with a target at 93 and 103. Support at the 80 MA broke and now the 50 must hold. CAR swing from March continues to trend nice and steady. as an analyst today gave a target of 57, I believe. Can't remember exactly. So earlier posted in the room, please go look it up. And 49 is the resistance that we need to break all-time high. My next target is 51, above there 55 and 59. Support of 47 and 45, basically the 50 simple moving CARV, what an incredible day trade. And Susan, congratulations. This is a Susan pick as a swing idea back here. Struggled through the point, came down at the 50 simple moving average, broke, recovered yesterday, and today explosive on massive volume. It was also a day trade for us that we caught a good part of it. And this obviously was covered during the pre-market. If you caught any move, you were able to get on board before this rally. It was a good run, 20, 23, 27, 31, and 37 reached those targets in a matter of less than an hour. And then a pullback. When something rallies this much and then opens on the red and it's halted, like here it opened on the red, stabilized, and went up. Here it opened and it was halted. Usually is the indication that it's going to roll over. So the next opening, it is obviously open lower, down at the support. And this was the exit when you got this bounce. Went down again. And then eventually stabilized, formed this triangle, posted in the room again that was ready to break. And it did. It popped, reached the target 37, then became a triple top, 37, 83, and then eventually rolled over, wasn't able to break it. So this is done. And but the volume is massive. I think this was one of the pumps, ready pumps. Please correct me if I'm wrong, posted in the room. And I don't have access to those groups, but some of you do. So if you see something, post something. And if he comes back above, now this is into all-time high territory. No, far from over. So there's a possibility if he comes back above this this 2330 resistance, it could rally some more. But again, be careful because extremely volatile. Down at 21 in the after hour market. And the support is this low at 16. Chewy got a bounce off the 50 simple the moving average, testing the 80 May. Needs to come back above 82. The 80 May, 82. Yeah. My target, the number volume today is a little bit discouraging, but I want to see it back above the 80 May and eventually move above 84. The Wilson was good. If the market gets weaker, it could pull back as well. I'm looking for 88, 96, and 104. Coin got a bounce off the 21 simple moving average. This is the solid support we have at this point. But again, below the 50 simple moving average. Frustrating because yesterday made a good move and today back below where it started. Nevertheless, the lower shadow indicates some buying pressure, the presence of buyers. And now we need to see a break of the trend line and the 50 simple moving average, and eventually move above this recent high at 261. If we get that, targets are 276, 310, and 351. Support is the 29 simple moving average and 223. CrowdStrike recovered also, got a bounce, continues to close above the 18 A, stays long as price closes above the 8. Next targets 280 and 300, support today low and this doji low at 245. DDD is a swing idea that worked nicely through here. Triple top and then rolled over, broke the 18 A, this was the place to exit. But all the way down to the 34 EMA and 33, this was the breakout level, 33, today low, 32.17. It's a little bit of a reversal. Was making a piercing line. It didn't quite close to make a piercing line, which would be half of the candle, the previous day candle. Volume, though, is increasing, so it's a bounce of the 34, that is the line in the sand. It needs to come back above the 80 May, and if this is a triangle formation, maybe a flag, and breaks out, 38 is the resistance. Moving forward, 42, 46, and 52 are the targets. If it recovers, it needs to confirm the pattern. Doku also got a bounce of today low at 279.50. Target was reached yesterday, 293.70, moving forward, 330 and 378. Support 80 MA, and we're looking at this low at 269. Etsy also a bounce of the trend line, currently confirming the breakout and testing the breakout low, 187.77, 185.10, so a brief drop below it, but recovered. Well, this is a piercing line with decent volume, needs more to confirm. And eventually, I want to see a break above the 207.87. Targets moving forward, 28, 260, and 295. Support today, low. And then further down, the 50 simple moving average. For Solar, also similar pattern as with the Hammer. I remember which one. Oh, CHWY. Back above the 80 MA. It's okay. I want to see a back above this 94. This is the resistance we're looking at, 94.08, 94.08, double top. He needs to recover and go above it. If he makes the break and goes, the target moving forward, 98, 104, and 110. The support at the 80 MA today. A FUBO also seems to be a re-entry opportunity. This also was a swing for us through there. So, idea. Broke below the 80 MA, rolled over very hard, got a bounce off the 50 simple moving average and closed well at 20, 29, near 29. And piercing line with volume, decent volume. Needs more to extend with the soccer, the final coming up. This is a football channel. You might get some traction and get some, a couple of weeks, a couple of days run. The game is on Sunday. Italy, England. 33, go item. 36 and 39 are the targets. Moving forward, and the support is this low, 27.50, and the 50 simple the moving average. GN, a day trade that did nicely for first part of the morning, where it did this consolidation, broke out of the triangle top, came as high as 17.20. Sorry, 1792, wasn't able to get above 18, and then it pulled back, broke the moving averages, broke the VWP, and pulled back further. Eventually, it was able to come back above the VWP. So it closed decent. This is a reverse of bullish kicker with volume and fill the gap. So let's see if it gets more momentum. Looking for 1965 and the 200 simple moving average. 21 and 22.50 support 80 MA and today. GLOP was mentioned by Susan 3 days ago. Keep watching it. The volume is fantastic on Tuesday. Today closed well. I added to the swing idea as it started closing above the 508 and 503, 503 and 508. And this is a bullish pattern with decent volume today. My target is 546, this high, that's 593, 619, 670, and 763. Support, I'm looking at today low, 460 and the 80 MA. MOXC, another fantastic day. Susan Swing idea, this is very bullish and strong. They broke above this recent high, 2670, 2657. My target moving forward, 31, 36, and 42. Support, we can now say half of the candle, 24, and this low, 20, 24 and 20. Nike, also decent consolidation, with the high 161.50. My target, first target, it was 165. Moving forward, 178 and 190. Support, 80 MA, and then the breakout low at 150. NF, NDFY, Subo found this one, massive volume. It's in the housing and fixture, which is a pick for some of those Reddit groups and some of those companies crashed. You know, this came for 25, no, 50. So multiple splits, most likely. What was it? The high was into the 50 and 45. And also, this is a sector with people remodeling their homes and all those things that could get some momentum moving forward. Anyway, this was a day trade that, let me see, was spotted around this time. So this had a good move after the reopening, with the target at 610, double top, and then rolled over. Now it's going again, 620. So this might have some more energy tomorrow. Keep an eye on it. And if you are swinging it, the support is five, and then fell down at the ATMA. That's, we're talking $2. That's a lot of risk. I personally am not willing to take, but some of you are uncomfortable with that. Sometimes pays off well. 8, 9, 12, and 15 are the targets. Path, a reversal. I know very little about this company. I only know that Cathie Wood loves this company. It's one of her favorite AI. And most importantly, bought large chunk of shares over the past, I think on Tuesday, was 850,000, 70,000, plus a separate bunch of 450 each thousand. So, but what I like is this base and above 61, that's our secondary support. Primary support is 64. It's a reversal today, engulfing, needs volume to confirm. I enter a position today, I like this base. So let's see if it does what it's supposed to do, a good rally after a reversal like that. And but it's also very volatile, so do expect, like you see, the bullish engulfing here. Gapped up, gapped down, rally, rolled over. So expect this kind of behavior if you do trade it. And for if you want to risk less, it's after today candle and then today low at 63.60. Pins, sell signal yesterday, got a bounce off the 21 simple, the moving average, number volume is increasing. This is not a buy signal yet, unless he opens higher tomorrow, holds the support, which is the opening price today at 75.60 or today low at 74. Those are the two supports. If he opens lower and heads down, this thing is gonna go to 72, this low, 70, and then the 50 simple, the moving average. So the resistance moving forward, if he reverses, 85 and 92. PLTR had a reversal today, spotted dark pool activity, and I entered a position today, so with the stop for me at 22. There was a big dark pool activity at 22.50. So that's the level to watch, 22.50, 22. Obviously a lower opening. It will indicate a lower move. Now, sometimes those dark pool activities don't tell us the direction, tell us institutional position. And what I want to see next is a break, hold above the 50 simple the moving average with my target 25, 28, and then eventually 31. See if he gets there. And again, the support is 22. For me, that's the line in the sand. Below that is 21. But on a bit of a reversal also today after reaching the 124 or 129.26 target. Moving forward, if he breaks an old 130, looking at 149 and 171. Support today low. And right now is the 34 EMA. SGH popped. Yesterday, pullback retest. At one point, was making a hammer, which looked good. This is a bearish harami. I'm thinking of it as a profit taking. So far, it's confirming the breakout point, but it needs to hold. So the support are the 53 level where he opened, and then today low, yesterday low, 51. So those are two tight supports. And if he breaks below the level, the next support level is this high at 43, at 49, 49, 30, 49. I'm looking for 64 and 71 moving forward. Space, incredible trade today. A reversal, a good action, reached the target at 50, broke out or attempted to break out the trend line. My target at 59, 71, and 87. This is a swing. We re-entered this day when it pulled back. That was a great re-entry. Support remains the ATMA, so let's give a number, 47 and 43, 47 and 43. TTD swing, like everything in the market, opened lower, and it closed up in the green and above the ATMA, testing the trend line. Number volume increase, I need to see it above, first of all, this high, 79, and then eventually this high, 81. 79 and 81, those are the big resistance areas. My targets are 86, 97, and 110. Support is 76, and today low 73, 74 level. UONE, a day trade, was very powerful the first part of the morning, where it popped and ran. Quickly reached the first target at 980, came as high as 11, 12. My target was 1150. And then double top, broke the VWP, got a bounce, looked like I wanted to go again, but then weakened and rolled over. So this was done at that point. On the daily chart is a lot of volume and a bounce of 7 with a bullish kicker. So this could be a reversal with 1150, 1330, and 15 the next targets if gets gone. Support is to the low. And finally, EXLA. EXLA, this is all over the place. So swing idea that was mentioned multiple times today popped, reached the target at 370, and then immediately rolled over. So now this is a sell signal with number volume increase. And the support, first primary support was broken, which was this high, 310. Secondary support was looking at this level at 260. Right there, it's right there. So that is the secondary level today low. Any move below that, the ATMA, the low, and down at the 50 simple moving, and down at the 34 EMA. So be careful with this one. Again, extremely volatile. It's bullish, but the volume is a concern. All right, folks, thanks for watching and good trading. We'll see you tomorrow.